How you doing? This is Tom from Tiny Landscaping. A few people have asked about our laser setup, so we thought we would do a short video trying to explain how we do things. First off, I use a Topcon slope laser. The difference between a regular laser and a slope laser is a regular laser only shoots level, where this has these arrows up and down, so we can adjust the laser one direction or the other, and that can be used for slope. Secondly, when we figure out slope, 1/8 inch per foot is 1%. So in the video, we're working on a swale. It's 36 feet long, so 1/8 inch per foot would be 4.5 inches from one side to the other. So you take the 36, you can either divide by 8 or you can multiply by 0.125, and that will give you your 1% grade. 2% obviously would be double that. As soon as we finish that part of the swale, then we move to laying the pipe. I move a little bit further down. That section was 58 feet long. Multiply that by 0.125 and you get 7.25 inches. So that's how we figure out our slope as we're going along. The other part that I didn't explain good in the video was this grade rod, which I absolutely cannot do without. It just takes all the math and the guesswork and just makes it very easy to set up real fast and just get to work. The difference between this and a regular grade, first off, it's a regular grade rod on one side, and on this side it works different. And what makes it different is it has a zero in the middle and then measurements in both directions. So you would find your zero and you would set the laser. You just tighten this down. So I got my zero, and then if I need to go -4 from there, I just go boom, -4, I'm set. And then if I need to go further down, I got to go -8, because it's got an 8 there, or if I need to go back to 4, 2, whatever it is, or it just makes it easy. There's none of this trying to figure out 72 -6.25 kind of stuff. So that just makes life much easier, and it just makes the setup really quick. The last part is by putting the receiver on the boom. What that does is turn the boom into a grade rod. So the only thing you have to remember is you have to have your bucket in the same position when you set up every, and take your measurement every time. So when I do it with the bucket all the way out. So I will come in and take a scoop, turn around, dump that out. I leave my bucket all the way out. I come around and I go right back down in the hole and I can take my measurement. I take another scoop, come around, dump it, leave the bucket open, and I go right down, I take my measurement, and I'll do that almost every time I dump, and that way I can keep going right along and everything is, no up and down. Some people like to do it with the bucket curled. I think it's, for me, it's much more difficult because if the bucket isn't in the exact same curl position, your measurement can change. So all the way open, it just makes it easy. So I hope you like our video. This was our attempt to try to show how how we have our laser set up and how we, do our drainage work or pavers, every day. Okay, thanks.
That's your zero.
We want this to be -4, so now we set this to -4. That's the middle. You want that to be -1, right?
-1, yeah.
Hey, this is the bathroom, right?
Yeah, it actually is. Okay, let me dig down until we get -1 here. Now, do you want all of that? Okay, so we're setting up a swale here. We're doing the same pitch, 1/8 inch per foot. So first thing I have to do is dig this down. Our zero is over there, just so we remember we have the same. So over here I want to be -1 from there. So we're going to dig down to -1 once we set this. Then we go down to the other end and we dig that to our measurement down there. And then we can set our slope on the laser, and then we'll have the perfect slope going the whole way that I can see on the machine, and it'll be, perfectly sloped, so, okay.
Bring your machine up so I can dump in the bucket.
I'll hold up for a minute.
Side, and then we'll slope the laser.
I'll hold that here. So it's 5.5, right?
Right.
Hmm?
Yep. Let me come back a little more, then. Because the laser's level, and I'm minus 5.5 down there, this is like really, really high. So I'm gonna set this back to -1. -1 and -5.5 down there. If we go down there and put this in the same spot, now we can change the laser from being level to sloped, and it'll give us a perfect pitch all the way down. And then we set the laser, the receiver on the machine, and we can dig perfect. I'm gonna bring the laser down here.
You tell them if it's going up or down.
Exactly straight up and down, right? Kind of level?
It's just good, just like that.
Good. It's good?
It's good.
Get up here.
The one downside to the tripod is that you can move it up on top.
So if it's a down arrow on this, you have to actually move up on
it. It should be right. See? good. Okay, so now. Wait. Put that in. I'll just explain. So here we're minus one, and we're on the money, or close enough. And if we go down there with the thing, with the receiver in the exact same spot, we'll be in the same position. So we have a perfect slope all the way down, and I will set the machine to that. Okay. Let's put the laser on the machine. So we made this here post to go on the machines. It's an 1¼-inch square tube, and I got some magnets off of Amazon just so we can move it from machine to machine.
A lot of machine noise.
We turn the laser receiver on, and now all we have to do That's it. Now I got a perfect setup on the machine. There's a lot better guys that explain this than me. I learned this from Dirt Ninja 10, 12 years ago. He had a great video. That's Dirt Ninja. Digging OK had a really good video. So not that hard, and it makes you dig perfect.
Take two.
Wait. Okay. So our swell is all done. It's not as perfect as I would have liked because we hit some big boulders, and I still got to dig another big one right here. But this is about 36 feet long, I think it was. It's a perfect 1% slope. So it's dropping 4.5 inches from one side to the other, minus one to minus 5.5. I did it so there's a 6-inch drop between the house to the center. And then, like I said, it looks more rude right now because we got to flare it all out on both sides and flare into the hill. But for the most part, this is done. And this is how we do the laser, whether it's set to a slope or it's when we do the infiltrators, the chamber systems, we would set that to level and I will dig the whole thing that way. It just, you make sure that you dig to the right height. Once it's done, you don't have to go back and do it over again. You're not over digging, moving more dirt than you need to. And we will do this over and over and over again. I'm going to put the catch basin in here. I'm going to set my first pipe. And then I'm going to go down to the other end, do the same thing, dig down, set the laser so I got a perfect laser line between. And then we'll just dig that all the way down. And then we'll turn and dig towards the catch basin, like I said. So we got a perfect slope, no over digging, and it's all done right the first time. So, like I said, I am using the Topcon slope laser, single slope. And this is the Spectra receiver. It's a magnet mount. I would have liked to have gotten the Topcon one, but it was $200 more. So I was basically paying $200 just so it would fit in the same case. This works perfect. It works both ways. I can have it on one side or the other, whether it's this way, let me find it right there, or if I put it on the other side of the machine, you turn it over, it's the same thing, up and down. It's just the beeps will be wrong if it's upside down like it is now. But that's our setup, that's how we do it, whether we're working on slopes or we're working level. So I hope you liked it. I know I didn't explain it as good as some guys, but I said Dirt Ninja, awesome video. This is how I learned how to do this, I don't know, 10, 12 years ago or something like that. He's got at least a couple videos that explained exactly how to do it, and that's how I bought the right stuff, and that's how we did it. So the whole video of this job will be up shortly. Thanks for watching. I hope it helped you. Thanks.
Okay, here's our swale. Here's our 1 20-inch basin.
Here's me.
Here's Nick. And as you can see, is perfectly pitched, going all the way down, thanks to the laser. We graded away from the house towards the catch basin. And I don't know if you can see that, but there is a little check dam right after the basin to stop any water. But if in big rainfall, the water can go over it, and they have a natural swale that goes to the street.